Okay, mm-hmm. So this will be 1 hour demo session. So mm-hmm. I just try to clarify your doubts, any doubts or any questions if you have about AngularJS framework. Okay, mm-hmm. And I'll take you through some points basically, some mm-hmm. questions like in the form of, you know, like whenever you start to learn a new technology, you will be getting some questions, okay, that what right. it is and why I need to learn it, okay. So mm-hmm. these are the some questions in the form of what, when, you know, how, where. So I'll try to address these questions, and if you, I have these agendas basically, and if you have any questions or anything, you can add here also, okay.
Sure.
Yeah. So first of all, you know, for AngularJS, the prerequisites that we have basically. So what are the prerequisites? I think you already have started, so you know that. Okay, so you need the knowledge of HTML, Python, CSS,
okay.
JavaScript. Mm-hmm. Okay, so this is needed. And if you have, you know, jQuery and Angular 1, as you are planning to learn Angular 2, so if you have Angular 1, then that will be an advantage for you actually. Okay, so these are the yep. prerequisites. So you have experience with HTML5, you have worked with this yes. HTML5 applications before, or this is the yes, first project?
I will tell you, actually I learned myself and I delivered the project yesterday.
Oh,
yesterday
okay, that's a great thing. Okay. Okay, fine. That's a good thing. Okay, fine. So then there is no problem actually. Okay, so I have, you know, I'll take you through the topics that I have basically for the Angular 2 syllabus. I'll go through that thing also. Okay. So okay. before that, let me clarify what is AngularJS framework, okay, and why AngularJS is needed basically. Okay. So the questions will come basically here for both Angular 1 and Angular 2. So I'll try to address it for both the version.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. So what is Angular basically? It is an open source framework. Okay. So and what kind of framework? It is a JavaScript framework. It's not a .NET or Java. Okay. It is a JavaScript framework. So framework that is developed and created, you know, in JavaScript, and it is meant for the JavaScript applications. Okay. So you can write here that it is open source. First of all, it is open source JavaScript, you know, framework. Right, so it is JavaScript framework. So open source JavaScript framework, and why it is needed basically, it is used for developing web applications. You can develop web application. So web applications means it can be, you know, desktop or mobile, tablet, anything. Okay, so it can be desktop, it can be mobile, it can be any devices basically. So it is an internet based application you can develop. You can develop mobile applications also, not only the mobile, I mean the responsive websites, but you can develop mobile applications as well. Like, you know that Ionic framework is used for developing mobile applications for any platform. Okay, so there are many such frameworks are available, and with AngularJS you can develop this kind of applications. Now, one more thing specifically, that is this framework uses, you know, the basic technologies. What are the basic web technologies we have basically? The basic web techs we have, you know, HTML, CSS, and JavaScript.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
But with Angular 2 basically, you can develop Angular 2 applications with JavaScript as well, but mostly, you know, it is preferred to use TypeScript. I'll come to that topic also, what is TypeScript and why you need TypeScript, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so Express.js is used with Node.js, not with Angular basically. Okay, so...
Got you.
Yeah. So basically, that you need to know HTML, CSS and JavaScript. If you know these things, you can learn TypeScript, you can learn Angular 1 or 2 also. Okay, now what is focus? Its main focus of AngularJS, you know, framework, it has been on single page application. I don't know whether you heard this or not, single page application.
Yeah, Yes.
Open application, it is a kind of type of application. Basically, nowadays you will see most of the websites, you know, are based on this design, single page application. Okay, and this has been very, very popular. So this is a new kind of applications, and not the traditional websites. If you open any single page applications, there you see that navigation, user interactions are very fast and so intuitive basically. Okay, so that is the single page application. I'll take you through that topic in our course. What is single page application, how and how we can create single page application. In AngularJS, you know, that AngularJS uses another design pattern that is called MVC, Model View Controller Design Pattern. So it is, that MVC is a pattern that is basically one of the old pattern, you know, in software industry, in software technology basically. So, and that MVC pattern is very, very popular for the web development. It has been, you know, there at the server side for a long time. We have this pattern for Java, .NET, PHP, Ruby on Rails. So for all the most, you know, mostly popular frameworks are having this MVC pattern. Okay. And with AngularJS, we have got that MVC pattern at the client side as well. So this is one of the remarkable feature of AngularJS, that you can, you know, create your applications using MVC design pattern. And it uses another pattern that is called MVVM. So MVVM and MVC and MVVM design pattern. MVVM means Model View V Model. Okay. So this is again another pattern basically that is used for developing applications. This is also another design pattern. So it uses both of these patterns.
Okay.
And all these patterns are architectural pattern, means how to architecture your application. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. So any question?
I'm good.
Okay, fine. So now question is that the what part I have covered, you know, that what is Angular and what you should already know, and what we are going to learn in this course basically. So I have two courses for Angular 1 and Angular 2. Your requirement is Angular 2. So this is our Angular 2 syllabus. Okay. And so these are the topics basically I have. Is it okay, or I should zoom it?
Yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah. Okay. So here we have basically, you know, the first chapter we have that what is, you know, AngularJS 2 and scope of Angular. So those things will be discussed here. Okay, and how to set up the AngularJS applications, the installation, I mean. Okay. Now next chapter is basically the npm. You know npm. Have you used npm?
Yeah, I started using npm. I mean, by seeing this npm, I have a question. Actually, this AngularJS 2, I mean, do we need to use only npm, or whether it can be deployable on the Tomcat server also?
No. See, basically, thing is that why npm is used basically. Npm is a node package manager, okay, and this is nothing but a command line tool basically. You can say command line commands basically. Using this command, you can install the dependencies. Okay, so deployment is a different thing. Okay, deployment is a different thing. You can deploy your developed application in any server. You can develop in any cloud. Okay, but thing is that if you develop it for Java, then also you can deploy. That doesn't matter actually. Okay, it is only used for the development, including the dependencies. Deployment is a different thing. There is no issue with the deployment. You can deploy your Angular 2 application in any server, because this is a completely client-side server. Client-side tool actually. Okay.
I'm sorry, Aditya. Just actually, the question here is, I'm trying to deploy one of the AngularJS 2 application in the Tomcat 7 server, but it is somehow it is not supportive version or something. I don't know. But that's why I'm asking. Is there any prerequisite or any of the what kind of application server we may need to use for this AngularJS?
See, basically, I have not checked out that Tomcat one. Okay, I can tell you about, you know, the Azure Cloud, Heroku, or in the IaaS I have deployed. I have not worked with the Tomcat. But I will say one thing, you know, that if you have the NPM, okay, so first of all, what you can do basically, you can copy the whole thing, whatever you have basically in your project, okay. And if you have NPM there at that server, okay, so you can run the NPM, you can run the build, you know, using NPM, you can build that application in the for production, okay. Once it is built, you know, for production, then you can, you'll see it will create a folder actually, the deployable unit that is called, right. And then that folder you can copy to your web server, that I know basically. It can be Tomcat, it can be IIS, it can be PHP, it can be anything. Okay, but what issue you are getting, that if you can send me the error list, error type or screenshot of that, then I can tell you on that, what is that error actually. But there is nothing to do basically, no special things for Tomcat. You just need to create the deployable unit basically using npm build products command. If you are not doing that thing, if you are simply just copying your source file, then you might have the issues. So getting my point?
Actually, see, I will tell you, I mean, today afternoon, what I tried, I will tell you. You know the IDE IntelliJ, right? From the IntelliJ, we deployed that one of the templates from the internet, and we converted that template. That template is running on the IntelliJ, and as well as the npm run server or something. So if I use the both the things, it's the 4200, port 4200 is working, and as well as 8081 is also working because IntelliJ is using 8082. Because my development server, I mean, that is my local system, and whenever I am trying to push this code into our test server or the deployment server, that is the Tomcat, Apache Tomcat 7, okay? So that time what I did, I converted into the WAR file, and I will try to deploy the WAR file. But it is not working. Okay. Actually, the page got launched, but it is not going inside the AngularJS 2 framework.
Okay, that means the home page is coming. The launch, it is getting launched, but they're not able to navigate to other links.
Okay, so what do you mean to say? There will not be any dependency for AngularJS?
Yeah, see, there is basically, in that case, what you need to check, you check your, your index page, your home page, okay. Check your, the base settings, the base URL, base tag, what you have there basically.
Index page is coming up.
You can check in your index page, just check the base tag. This one.
Base tag.
If you are having a navigation issue, I'm just, I'm just trying to just imagine, I'm not sure it can be. Just try to put this thing for Tomcat, and for IIS server generally we put the slash. Okay. See if you have this base tag configured or not. If you are having the navigation issue. Okay.
This was not configured. The only the app route or something is configured there. App route, app route, home, app route. That's all. That is the only thing. It is there in the HTML or index.
You can try this. We need to give the base URL actually. So for .NET Server IIS we give slash, and for Tomcat or Java we give a dot. Okay, just you try to add this one. Not added, it might still the issue. Okay, so that I can know that you can check basically what is the issue. So this is our syllabus.
Okay.
So in the NPM, how to work with NPM basically, how to use NPM. Okay, so that I will learn here. Next I have, TypeScript and ES6. So you know that if you use the ES6 or ES2015, okay, you can create a class, right? You can, there are some features of ES6 basically. So those things you can use basically, and this is the best, best thing available in JavaScript. Okay. So here you learn what is TypeScript and the ES6 specifications. Okay. And how to install TypeScript, configure TypeScript, how to compile with TypeScript, and I'll tell you some information of ES2015 as well. Okay, so yeah, you need to know these things.
For AngularJS2, these standards, ES6 and ES2015, is it mandatory or is it optional?
No, see, this is not a kind of mandatory or optional. These are the standard. You heard about ECMA 6? ECMA script 6?
No.
Okay. See, basically, this is the latest standard of JavaScript. Okay. And this Angular 2 uses ES6 basically. That ES 2015 or 6, whatever you say. Okay. So, as you say, you may not write using ES6, that is not mandatory, but it is generally it is done with ES6, because their AngularJS 2 is providing you, it supports ES6 basically, and this is the latest standard we have. Like, you can create class using ES6, right?
Okay, so, got it.
So that is the benefits you will be getting basically. If you use ES6, then your code will be more modular, it will be having more using the modern JavaScript basically, right? So you'll be having a modular JavaScript, you'll be having the features of ES6 modules, so many things will be getting basically.
Okay.
So it's always suggested that you should use ES6 or ES2015.
Okay.
Now, next we have component, and you know that in Angular 2, everything is based on component, it is component oriented. Okay, so whenever you are creating an application, it is nothing but you are creating some components for your application. And all those components are basically, you will be creating a tree of components, and that tree will represent your application.
Okay.
So here we learn about these things, the components, the data binding we have next, what is data binding, one-way data binding, two-way data binding. Okay, so those things we learn here. Directives, if you have started in Angular 1, we have this topic in Angular 2 as well. The directives, you can create directives if you want to create custom HTML elements or attributes. Okay, so you can create directives. Now, next is the service and dependency injection. What is service? Is basically in AngularJS, we have services. If you want to have your common implementations, the common logics, you can place in some in a component that is called a service basically. And this is used for sharing purpose. You have some logic that you want to share in your application into different components, you can create a service. So here you will learn how to create a service, how to register a service, how to work with the dependencies. Okay.
Is it similar to AngularJS 1, the service?
Yeah, the concept is similar actually. Concept is similar, same as Angular 1.
Okay.
Now, that advanced components we have, how to communicate between components. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So style with scoping with special selectors, metadata, style URL. So there are some advanced things we have basically that I'll show you. The forms basically you already have learned in Angular 1, you have seen that how to create a form in Angular 1, right? Similarly, how to work with that HTML form in Angular 2, that we learn here in this form chapter. And then how to validate forms, the form validation. Like, in HTML, at the client side, we have some basic validations like mandatory check, type checking, okay, format checking. So, those kind of validations we can do in Angular 2 as well. How to do that in Angular 2,
okay.
The form validation.
Okay.
Next chapter is very, very important. That is the HTTP. HTTP is something, you know, nowadays is very important. You know, everything is done using HTTP services, right? That is the REST APIs. Okay. So how to work with, you know, the HTTP basically, how to work with services, how to work with web APIs, REST APIs, how to, you know, consume a REST API in Angular 2. That we learn here. Okay. Next is the routing. I got that you are already having the concept of routing, right? So routing is nothing but configuring the navigations, right, of your application.
Yep.
So right. That is the modern URLs, you know, in the modern URLs, it is based on routes. Okay. So we need to configure the routes for the for our URLs.
Okay.
Pipes. You have pipes. This is also another concept, you know, in pipes. So here you learn the changes from Angular 1, you know, so deprecated pipes. So this is also another feature of, you know, Angular 2, pipes. I'll tell you what is that. Next, last chapter is our project setup. Project setup means basically the architecture of the project, how to build and run the app, how to create the deployable build. Okay, so all those things you learn here.
Okay.
And that's, you know, so total we have 14 chapters.
Okay. Yep. Total. I think we may need to, if at all we are starting, we may need to start from the 14th chapter.
Yeah. But not all actually. Some of the topics.
Okay.
You're right. Some of the topics will be covered.
Yes.
Okay. But definitely I'll not show you that how to deploy the project, right, on the first day.
No, actually I will tell you. The problem is, yeah. I'm working, right? So
yeah.
I have some project deliverables. Okay. After learning complete AngularJS 2, if I start delivering, my job will not be there. So that's why I have to work, I have to give the balance between learning and delivering.
Okay.
That's what I did for the AngularJS 1. So I parallel I am learning, parallel I am working. That's what, that's why I think this flow is very good, very nicely you framed this, the setup actually, the syllabus. Yes, but I mean, the chapter number 3, whatever you told, absolutely I don't have any idea, but I have idea in the chapter number 2. So those some setups, yes, definitely. I am little bit, I have some knowledge.
Yeah, that's a good thing. You already having some idea. So what you can do, if you're already, if you know some topic, I'll not waste the time. I'll move to the next topic then. Okay.
Right.
So
right.
So that will save some time also.
Yeah. Great. Okay.
Okay. So currently your project is in which stage basically? It's already in development stage or what?
Yes. See, they asked me to deploy one application in the development server.
Okay.
I could not able to do that one. That's why I'm asking few questions on that one. Okay. My development server, my local machine, I can use this whatever the way, I mean whatever the configuration I want, I can able to use right now. I'm using Eclipse is my IDE, and my application server I have to use as a Apache Tomcat.
Tomcat.
7, 8, whatever it is, version. You you name it, we can have that Tomcat version. Okay. But I have one application, that means one template, which the customer bought from the internet for the very, I mean, that application or the that template I need to deploy on the Tomcat.
Okay.
So when I started executing that template, that is working good in the one of the NPM environment. I can able to see the index.html, index.html, the index.html is redirecting to the Angular 2 framework, and it is displaying lots and lots. Okay. But somehow I could not able to complete or deploy on the that application in the Tomcat. So that's where I really stuck actually.
Okay.
So yeah, I mean, definitely. Okay, and can I ask you a few questions?
Yeah.
Do you have any application installed in your machine at this moment?
No application. No application.
Any of the I think my question may be wrong. Any of the Angular JS 2 based some project is installed or the deployed in your machine?
No, it is not deployed actually. It is not deployed. No project is installed in my system.
Okay.
I just only create the project and show it in a debug mode, but I don't deploy. Okay. Because for deploying, the thing is that my system is already having so many frameworks and all. Because not only this Angular, I have 3-4 IDEs installed, database servers, I have 2-3 database servers, application servers, so many things are there basically. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fine.
Yeah. So which IDE you will be using? You are using NetBeans.
Eclipse
you are using. Okay, fine. Okay. Yeah, I use, VS Code. Any problem with that VS Code if I use that?
Which one?
VS Code, Visual Studio Code.
Okay. See, my application is based on the Java-based application.
Java-based, yeah, I got it. Your application is Java-based, that's why you're using Eclipse actually.
Perfect.
So how, you have there the RETL, that command line, command window, in Eclipse?
I didn't get to say one more time.
RETL window, RETL. RETL, the command window.
I don't know.
You don't know that. Okay, so how you are installing the dependencies through NPM in Eclipse?
Okay, that's where. Okay, I installed the. How I did is NPM using NPM. I have installed all the dependencies.
Okay, but which you have installed any command tool? You have Git or what? Like we have GitBash, right? So you can install
Git.
You can use.
We are using Git. Yep.
Okay, so you can do that using GitBash, right? Or there are some IDEs that there you have integrated RETL window. This is nothing but a RETL window, right? Git. Okay. So.
Yep.
It is GitBash. So GitBash is installed in my system. So you need a RETL window, right? If you want to work with Angular 2, means if you want to do some work with NPM, you need some RETL. You need a RETL window, right?
Okay.
So even you can do it in DOS or PowerShell also. That's a different thing. But using this RETL, Git or if you have a Linux system, then it's a good in Linux by default it will work. Okay, so that's a very straightforward basically. But nowadays, in most of the IDEs, you'll be getting the integrated RETL, integrated this command window actually. Like in VS Code, we have that thing integrated. Okay, so there are some more UI tools like Sublime, Text, or WebStorm. There also you can configure your IDE. For the, for this Angular 2 or Node development, and there you can use integrated RETL window basically. Okay, so you are doing it through Git actually, GitBash. So yeah, I use GitBash also. Sometimes I use GitBash, sometimes I use the integrated command line tool.
Okay.
Using integrated is more straightforward, but it's nothing. The commands are same basically.
Okay.
You can execute the command anywhere. So I use Visual Studio Code. You let me know if you face any problem in the class. Okay, so when I'll start, I'll give you some brief about the VS Code. And okay. But you know, Eclipse is not installed in my system.
Okay.
But I have that tool actually. It was installed. Later I removed it because my laptop has been very slow recently. Okay.
Okay.
So anyway.
No problem. That doesn't matter actually.
Yeah, actually, you know, in my system I have the cloud setup and all. So because of that, I had to remove some applications. So if you want, I can install Eclipse as well for a few days. That's not a problem.
It's okay, no problem. It's okay, no problem. I can manage.
You can manage it. Okay, no problem. You can share. So whenever you face any issues, you know, you can share your screen and you can show me, or you can send me the screenshot of the error. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. That we can do. That works.
Yeah. So that is our syllabus, okay? And you know, I'll be going, you know, step by step with this course basically. And though you are learning, so if we jump around the topics, then you know, we can lack you know, the continuation. So that can be the problem. So you have to decide basically. You have to work hard for that as well as. But I, of course, I'll help you. You know, if you face any problem with your project, I'll try to help you out. That's not a problem. But you know, we should follow a particular pattern, particular flow actually. Okay.
I definitely I'm with you, Aditya. Okay.
Yeah.
We need to follow. I definitely, if we jump here and there, definitely that will not flow in a good manner. Definitely that may cause a lot of confusion, basically.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
Can I share my screen? Is it possible with this tool?
I don't know. You can share. I need to ask Venkat.
Show my screen. Yeah. Something needs to stop.
Mr. Ashok,
yeah.
You can share your screen now.
Go ahead. No. Actually, see, how I got this one? Are you controlling or somebody has given access to
No.
My screen?
Mr. Ashok, actually, I can pass you the controller, okay?
So the questions that I'll try to you know, address here, that is why AngularJS, first of all? And I'm expecting that answer from you because you are already developed application in Angular 1 as well as you are learning working in Angular 2. So why AngularJS? What is the need of AngularJS basically? Okay, fine. Yeah, see basically, you know, there is lots of good features in Angular. Okay. So that's why it is called a super heroic framework because of its features. Okay. And there are many reasons basically that why you should learn AngularJS. So why AngularJS? It can be the answer can be different for different people actually. For the client, the answer can be different. The reason can be different. For the developers, the reason can be different. For architects, the reason can be different. Okay, so there can be different reasons, you know, for the based on the requirement. So when a company is investing on a new technology, okay, what they will look into that? They will check whether his project requirements, you know, can cater that framework or not, right? So if you talk about some high level requirements, basically high level feature of any framework, like, you know, how easier would be the integration, like you have a Java application, right? Java application. So how easier would be the integration of Java and Angular? Okay, I have an application with .NET. I want to use AngularJS for .NET. I have a Node.js application. So I want to integrate this. So how easier is the integration with the Angular framework and other technology, other server-side technology? That is one thing, that integration. This is a very important parameter, the integration, right? If it is not integrated easily, then there is no point of investing on this, right? So there are so many frameworks available nowadays. Technology is changing very fast. So it must be flexible enough to integrate itself or to, with the future technologies as well. And you know that it is very fast, it is at a very fast pace that technology is changing. Today we are working with Angular 2. We don't know after 1 year what will come here, right? Angular 2 can be there, or there can be new things also. You can work on a new technology as well. Okay, so there are so many things basically. When I talk about integration, it can be Java, it can be .NET, It can be the telerik controls, it can be Ionic framework, it can be Node.js, so many things are there in the web development, right? So how we can integrate this thing? So that is the integration. Okay, now one more thing is that basically some other features like user interface. So when you choose any UI framework, first of all you will see that whether my user interface, you know, how easy it is, how intuitive it is to develop, right? So that is also another parameter for the UI frameworks, JavaScript framework. So Angular just uses HTML, you know that, okay, which is basically declarative. Okay, so you can use use a declarative user interface here, and so you don't need to learn a new things basically. You need to don't need to learn a new technology for creating your user interface. The HTML is a basic thing, so it is supposed to learn by everyone, right? So that is the another benefit, that you just need HTML concepts in HTML, some experience with HTML, that's all, because AngularJS uses HTML. Okay. Now another thing is that you know, the data binding. So you will see there are lots of MVC framework, right? Lots of MVC framework nowadays at the client side framework also, server side, not only the server side. So whether you know the data binding is supported or not, and how efficient is the data binding? Because data binding is such a thing, you know that in Angular 1 we have some issues, right? For two-way binding, if you have lots of bindings in a page, you know, it modifies the whole DOM actually, right? So that is the drawback of Angular 1. If you have lots of bindings basically, so in that case your page performance will be down. Okay. So that is basically the data binding, how the data binding works, how good it is, okay, and how easier it is, so that you have to check. Now this one is very, you know, flexible. It is a component oriented. You know what is a component and why a component is preferred basically? You will see that nowadays most of the frameworks are becoming component oriented, right? React.js, it's another framework, another competitor of Angular. This is also component oriented. And what is a component basically? Why we need component? Because components work as just a plugin, okay? Just pay and plug. Right? So if you have a component, in that case your application becomes more flexible. This is just a plug and play, because the components can be reused, right? And the components can be configured, the components you know, it works just like a module basically. So the component is more preferred than a tightly coupled code basically.
Got you.
Right, so it will give you more flexibility. So that is the thing basically. So it is more flexible. So it is basically the flexible, very flexibility. Another thing is the code reusability.
Okay.
In AngularJS, the code reusability coming from the component actually. The directives, components, those things will give you the reusability feature as well.
At the rate of symbols, okay, we will put the text symbol, right, Aditya? We will use the text symbols. Those are the, components, or those are the directives?
Yes. That way, you know, you need to define it using the directive. Okay.
I'm asking the question. So text symbol, are we using as a, in AngularJS 2, are we using as a directive, or are we using as a component?
We are using as a component. So when you create a component, we use @, okay, @ component.
Okay, got you.
Okay, so we use @ actually for defining a component, @ component.
Sure.
Now, next thing is that the AngularJS, as there is a code reusability, so there is less coding compared to other framework, or compared to the traditional, the old technology, like JavaScript or jQuery. So it needs less coding basically. That is another advantage of AngularJS. Okay. Nice. Apart from this, basically, yeah, tell me. Hello, you were saying something?
Hello, yeah. I went on mute. Sorry.
Yeah, you were asking something, right?
No, I'm not asking anything. No, actually what I said is less coding is very good. Nice.
Yeah. Less coding is, yeah, exactly. Yes.
Yep.
Okay, so AngularJS requires less coding. There is no doubt on that basically. Okay. So this, you know, these things minimize your number of codes in a project, and it takes less time, right? So that is the benefit basically. Okay. And last point I'll add here, that is you can test your Angular components. Okay, so it is easily testable. It supports testing. It supports unit testing basically. Okay, so that's a very good feature, that it is very hard to test a JavaScript code. It's really hard.
Okay.
And so next we have basically, so who developed AngularJS? I hope everyone knows this question. Even a child also can say it's a Google product, right? And who should use AngularJS? What do you think?
Anybody, any
web developer can use AngularJS. It works with any technology, be it Java, .NET, PHP. So any web developer can use it basically.
Yes.
Now, when to use AngularJS and when AngularJS release date, that's not required actually, the release date. So when to use AngularJS?
When our customer gives the money, we need to use.
Exactly. Okay, that's the question. Yeah. I told you on the introduction, that at the time of when I was talking about single page application, right? So first choice becomes, that single page application. So when the requirement is that your website should be a single page application, okay, then you have to look for what are the options you have for that.
Okay.
You have many frameworks, AngularJS, RealJS, Nokao, so many frameworks are there. Okay. So this is a choice for you, the Angular, if you want to create a single page application. This can be the reason to use AngularJS. Because it is a SPA framework. Okay, and if you compare with the SPA, the Angular with other framework, that comparison, every framework is having some merits and demerits. Okay, so that also with Angular also will be getting. So that, Angular is really different from Knockout, but there are some similarities as well. Okay, but AngularJS 2 is completely, brand new product, and it's completely different from Angular 1, right? So Angular 2 is going to be the future, and it is dominate the market, for a long time. Because there is no such product that you can compare with Angular 2 actually.
Okay.
Okay, so Angular 2 is really a kind of framework they have developed for, keeping in mind the future requirement. Like, it is platform independent, it can target any environment, you can create desktop applications, you can create mobile applications, you can create responsive applications, right? So,
right.
Basically, it is keeping in mind the modern requirements basically. Okay, and this is the direction, to that direction our technology is going actually.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's why I know that Google, they have just discarded their Angular 1 and they have started developing from scratch, with a new approach, right?
Okay.
You know that Angular 1 and Angular 2 is just a two completely different product.
Yes, I agree.
You cannot, these two are not,